Hey there! Welcome to another episode of Dear Blocko. This is the show where I answer your questions about your world and my world. Let's get started with our first question. Colin asks, Dear Blocko, what's happening while you're hypnotized? Is it even real? Actually, yeah, it is real, at least to some degree. It can work for certain people. In fact, it can be used along with other treatments to help with certain conditions. Research has shown it can be effective in combating things like stress, pain, and anxiety. It can also be used to help with weight loss. When someone is hypnotized, it's not really some sort of fictional mind control coming from a bard spell, but rather a trance-like state of heightened concentration. Some say it's like when you get really caught up in a book or a movie and you're totally focused on what's going on. The exact science around it is a little unclear, but some research has shown that it can affect multiple regions of the brain, like ones linked to pain perception and regulation, along with sensory processing and emotional response. Second question up, Dragon Trey asks, Dear Blocko, how do Venus flytraps digest things? That's a great question. This is certainly not gonna get creepy at all. From a basic level, Venus flytraps actually digest things in a way that's somewhat similar to the way humans digest food. That is, they use a stomach of sorts. While Venus flytraps do get some nutrients from more typical non-carnivorous plant methods, they're at their healthiest when they get further nutrition from insects, since the soil of their native environment is very nutrient poor. When an insect goes into the trap portion of the plant and triggers the hairs inside enough, the trap quickly snaps shut, locking the unfortunate intruder inside. The trap then essentially becomes a stomach, as special glands produce enzymes to digest most of the insect. This takes several days, after which the trap reopens and discards any leftovers. The extra creepy part? Venus flytraps usually don't close tightly over something that isn't moving, like if you try and feed one a dead insect. They basically aren't happy with their meal unless they feel it squirming around, which is essentially one of the grossest things I think I've ever said. And now it's time for questions about me and my world. Hooray! Kirana asks, Dear Blocko, what's a life-changing event that's happened to you? Love you, and thank you for making me curious about my world. Well, thank you so much for watching. Honestly, the life-changing event was starting this YouTube channel and getting to teach you all sorts of things. A less sappy life-changing event was when I got hit by a laser that came from space, and suddenly I can hear what the plants are saying. Unfortunately, I can't tell you what this flower just said, or I'll get demonetized. Joe R asks, Dear Blocko, have you ever made any art? Yeah, I can show you some of my art. Here's some of my pieces from various points in my life. This one is called Mess with the Blocko, You Get the Sago. I was an angsty teen when I made this. This one is very simple, just some text that says, The Earth is round. It's actually available on our merch store as a shirt. And this one is a close-up painting of my face. It took me a while to get all the details just right. So do you have any questions about your world or my world? Let me know right now in the comment section below and make sure you use the hashtag DearBlocko so I can find it. This episode of Life Noggin was sponsored by CuriosityStream, the world's first streaming service addressing our lifelong quest to learn, explore, and understand the world. Founded by John Hendricks, the founder of the Discovery Channel, CuriosityStream has over 2,400 documentaries and nonfiction titles from some of the world's best filmmakers, including exclusive originals. Get unlimited worldwide access starting at just $2.99 a month, and for our audience, your first month is completely free if you sign up at curiositystream.com/lifenoggin and use the promo code LifeNoggin during the sign-up process. If you love learning, which I think you might, click the first link in the description to sign up today. Do you want to watch even more Dear Blocko? Well, then you should probably check out this video. We're not really certain whether or not you're acting out your dreams, or if it even has anything to do with dreaming, but we do know that it can happen during different parts of the sleep cycle. Thank you so much for watching and liking this video, and as always, my name is Blocko, this has been Life Noggin, don't forget to keep on thinking.